Dear friends, welcome back. In this video, I am going to show you how to connect this 1.3-inch OLED display to your Raspberry Pi Pico board. I'll also show you how to use it with Arduino, and I'll share with you three useful projects to help you get started and save you a lot of time. Let's start. I recently discovered this OLED display and I wanted to try it out, because it is bigger in size than the OLED display I was using so far, which is just 1 inch in diagonal. The new display is 1.3 inches in diagonal, which makes it a lot bigger. Similar to the other OLED displays, this display has an excellent contrast and low power consumption. The display has a resolution of 128 by 64 pixels, it is a monochrome display, and it uses the I2C interface to communicate with the microcontroller. This makes the connection to the Raspberry Pi Pico extremely easy. All we have to do is to connect power and two more wires. Let's see how to connect it. The first pin of the display is the ground pin, so we connect it to a ground pin of the Raspberry Pi Pico board. The second pin is VCC, so we connect it to the 5V output of the Raspberry Pi Pico board. The next pin is named SEL, and we connect it to pin GP5, which is right here. It's the 7th pin of the board. The last pin is named SDA, and we connect it to pin GP4, which is pin number 6. That's it, our connections are ready. Let's power up the board to see what happens. As you can see, I have loaded a demo sketch to it, and it displays a Hello World message. Beautiful, our hardware setup is working fine. Let's now see the software we need to drive this display. I'm going to use Arduino today, so I open up the latest version of the Arduino IDE at the time of this recording. All we have to do is to click here at the Library Manager button, search for the excellent Giver OLED library and press the install button. Now that the library is installed, we can use it at once. As you can see, the code of the first example is very simple. All we do is we create an OLED object and we simply call some methods. At first, we initialize the display and then we clear it and we call the update method to reflect the changes to the screen. Next, we set the cursor to the desired X and Y coordinates on the screen, and we print the Hello World message with the print method. Next, we draw a frame around the screen with the rect method. And lastly, we send all the changes to the display with the update method. Easy, isn't it? The second example is a program that displays the temperature using a DHT22 sensor. I have connected the sensor to pin GP15. I have also included the DHT library to make it work. As you can see, the project is working fine and it updates the temperature every 2 seconds. The library only supports English and Russian text printing, but if we want to print the user interface in another language, we can load it as a bitmap and only print the numbers for the temperature with the library. For example, in Photoshop, I created a new .bmp file with dimensions 128 by 64 pixels, with the text temperature in Greek. I saved it as a .bmp file and I loaded it into the LCD assistant software. I then saved it to a .c file. The software created a byte array that I can use in my sketch. I just have to copy and paste it in my program. Now, instead of printing the text and drawing a frame using the library, I just call the draw bitmap function. Cool, huh? Our project now speaks Greek. By the way, if you find what I just shared with you useful, give this video a like so more people can learn about this easy procedure. Thank you very much. The last project I want to share with you is a Pong game where the CPU controls both paddles. I wanted to see if the display can update fast enough to allow us to develop games with it. As you can see, it is pretty fast. When I first ran the program, I was disappointed because the frame rate was not as fast. It was barely playable. But after some search, I discovered that if we manually set the I2C bus frequency at 800 kHz, the display works fast. Very cool. As always, you can find the code of the project in the video description. So this display is really fast using Arduino, and I'm going to use it a lot in the future. I am using Arduino and not CircuitPython or MacroPython because it is way faster in execution time. Please check the video comparison I did to see for yourself. If speed is an issue for your project, Arduino is the way to go. Thanks for watching, I'll see you next time.